Hi, I'm Scott Hansman. It's Azure Friday. I'm here with Elio Damaggio, and we're talking about Windows Azure Notification Hubs. This is an application service that's available, one of the many application services in Azure. So why should I care? What's a notification hub?
So a notification hub is an entity that you can provision inside of your Windows Azure account, which basically pushes notifications to mobile devices. And by mobile devices, actually, that includes Windows 8 desktop modern apps. So modern apps, Windows Phone apps, iOS apps, and Android apps.
Okay, so you said entity. This is like a service. I go new in my Azure portal.
Yes.
Can we make one?
Of course, let's create one.
Now, is this something that I have to use in an Azure cloud service, or can I do this at a, can I make a command line application or a Windows or an ASP.NET application use a notification?
This is an entity that is accessible from anywhere. The thing is that your devices registers to it from wherever they are. And then to trigger the notification, you have to contact this entity, and you can do it from a website, from a mobile services, from your on-prem website. And we do offer a REST API, so across platforms, Java, JavaScript,
okay,
PHP,
cool.
Perl, whatever you want.
Okay, I assumed that this would somehow be something that was in an Azure cloud service, but I have like lots of websites already. Like I'm making nerddinner.com. Could I have people register for notifications, and then when a nerd dinner is coming up, I can ping them?
You can totally do it. That would have to be an app on a mobile device. So if you have your own mobile app for your website that maybe adds other things, but one thing that usually people like about mobile apps compared to mobile websites is especially push notifications.
Okay.
You actually want to say something's new.
Okay.
And you can really do that very easily without having like other cloud properties or entities. You do not have to have your website running in the cloud to take advantage of this service.
Okay, cool. So later, I'm going to go and make this in the Xamarin tools, and I'll have an iPhone app and an Android app. Then I would want to use this.
That is correct.
Push that out. Okay, cool. Let's make one.
So here in Windows Azure, you go in App Services. You go under Service Bus, because we started as a Service Bus entity, and then you create a new notification hub.
So you are a part of Service Bus. You sit on top of Service Bus.
That is correct. We make use of Service Bus infrastructure underneath.
Oh, which makes sense, because Service Bus is kind of like a queue in the sense if you put the message in, it gets delivered.
Yes, that is correct.
All right, that makes sense.
So let's create a new one. Let's call it Azure Friday.
Do we want it in Asia?
Maybe not. We are in all data centers, so you can really choose the one that you prefer. I don't know.
We're in West US.
Let's do West US. And here is going to create a new namespace for this. Well, actually, I'm going to use one.
Well, you
that
have
I
an existing
have. I have one.
Service bus.
Yes.
And this
so
is just a compartmentalizing. It lists a place for it to live.
Yes. Basically, a namespace is like a container for your hubs. The important thing is that your billing will be tied to the namespace. So you can create a lot of hubs, and all the hubs that are inside the same namespace, you're going to be paid for all of them together, aggregated.
Oh, okay. Okay. So they're paid for together. Okay, cool.
So we're going to create this hub. It's going to show up here, Azure Friday.
Okay.
I have other hubs created.
Okay.
And in here, you see a dashboard where you can see all the pushes that I had. You see.
So this chart here, this isn't CPU. This is incoming messages and if there's been any trouble with
this. True. So there are all the incoming messages, there are all the successful notifications that you sent, and also other trouble. We actually have this monitor tab, which has a lot more of that. You have any, this is because every platform has its own push notification service, which we use, and each one of those has between like 10 and 20 different outcomes that they can provide you, and we relay all that information to you. You can have all these things in painful detail.
Yeah.
So who
uses this, like on my computer? Am I using this today?
Yes, you are. If you're using the Bing News app.
Yeah, I got that.
We basically broadcast the breaking news for Bing News app.
Okay.
So for us, the royal baby month in July was very, very hard.
So you pushed a toast, as we like to say. It's a piece
that
of toast.
That is correct.
The baby has been born.
The baby has been
millions
born.
Millions of these notifications.
Yes. Basically, we do the fan out, so you don't have to.
Mm-hmm.
We will basically contact all the millions computers that actually have that Bing News, and we make sure that it happens with a very low latency. If you do that on your own, that's probably a lot of work.
Yeah.
You have to have like multiple VM running in parallel, making sure that everything runs smoothly. It's really not
Well, that's a good point. There's no, I don't have to think about the underlying virtual machines. It's just a service.
This is just a service. There's no VM. There's no scaling, throughput, anything like that. Yeah. We just make sure that when you broadcast, things go out really, really fast.
All right, cool. So Azure Friday's got one now.
Okay, so then the first thing that you have to do is that you have to go in your configure tab and you basically have to set up the credentials to actually do the push. Why is that? We do not have a channel. We do not create like an explicit channel to your device. We use the platform notification service that each platform has. So in case of Windows, we're going to use WNS.
WNS, Windows which Notification Services. I guess that one.
Then okay. There is APNS, which you can guess that too.
Apple.
Push Notification Service.
Got it. Okay.
And then there is GCM for Android, which is a little harder.
Yeah.
Google Cloud Messaging. Okay. But basically, you can configure them here.
Okay, and so I would go to each of these people, Apple and Google and Microsoft,
exactly.
And get my credentials.
Exactly.
So this is kind of like when I make OpenID, I have to go to Twitter and Facebook and tell them about my app.
This is the same thing.
Okay.
So in here, in the Dev Center, I have an app that's called Elio App. I have many apps, actually. It's here.
Okay.
And if you navigate there, you basically come down to the services, to this specific thing.
So it's not secret anymore, but this is the secret for the Elio App.
That is correct.
And that's the app that's running on your machine that we'll send the notification to.
That we'll receive it. Yes, that we'll send the notification.
Yeah, it will receive it. Okay.
Yes. So basically from here, we take this stuff.
Okay. And then I assume that Google and Apple have similar unique secrets.
It's exact same things. Apple has a cert. You have to get to cert, but it's basically the same, same idea. You go back here. You copy paste these things. So we get the package SID. We get the client secret. And basically what we're doing now we have our hub is set up to send notification to my app through WNS.
Okay, cool.
Now we actually need an app. So let's go.
Isn't it the Elio app?
Yes. Elio app is just the one that I configured on the Dev Center. Now I have to code it.
Oh, sorry, I forgot about this. The little detail.
Writing
the app.
Writing the app. So we'll just create a new project. We're starting from scratch here, to show how easy it is. We're going to go in Windows Store and create a blank app.
Okay. This could be an iOS app, or it could be an Android app, or a Windows Phone app.
That is correct. Okay. So of course, if you're putting iOS, you have to be in Xcode and get a cert, but
sure.
It's the same things. In here, the first thing that we want to do is that we want to make sure that this is actually Elio app. So you go inside the store, and you associate this app with the store. You have to make sure to set the package SID. You have to make sure that WNS knows that this binary is Elio app.
So in the store, I know that I was going to put my game for babies called Baby Smash in the store. I told the store about it before it existed.
Yes.
Now I'm connecting the two.
Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
That makes sense.
So we sign in. Let's hope that I remember my password. But basically, what I do here, this is your store account.
Okay.
And
so this is making this new app that we're making. It's giving it a unique ID, and it's associating it with the credentials that we have for receiving a notification. And when I do these notifications, I can send them to everybody, like a breaking news, but can I also send it to a person?
Of course you can.
Yeah.
We have a mechanism that's called tags, which you can do it really, really easily.
Okay.
So in here, these are all the apps that I have in the store. I'm going to choose mine.
Okay, so he's saying Elio app, and then it says, all right, now app 3, file new project, is now Elio app.
Yes, if you go here in the app manifest, you will see that under packaging,
it's
Elio app.
Oh, and it has the package name. Okay.
It has all the stuff in here.
All right, cool.
Now, what we want to do, we want to send a toast, so we have to enable the toast. Go here in badges, we're going to say, actually, I want to be able
Toast
capable, yes.
All right, cool.
So we make sure that this guy can actually show toasts.
Got it.
Once we did that, we basically just have to make sure that when this app starts, it talks to the notification hub.
Okay, let's make the fonts a lot bigger, too. So we'll go down here and we'll do that for our friends.
Okay. Now, to do this, we're going to download the notification hub NuGet package.
Okay. And this is a library, a C# library. And do you have these packages on the other devices, or do I just use the REST endpoint?
No, we do have SDK in Objective-C for iOS. We have an SDK in Java for Google. And then we of course, have a managed SDK for Windows Phone 2.
Are those on GitHub or somewhere, open source?
The Android one is open source. The iOS is still in the process of being open source.
Very cool.
Online.
Okay, so you're in NuGet looking for notification hubs. Yeah, I don't like that either, when you type the search and then you have to type it again.
Yeah. Here it is. We're actually in the service bus thing, but you see that in here, it actually tells you that it's used for notification hubs.
Okay.
So you install this SDK. Now we have it here. What we're going to do now, we're going to do this. We're going to first create a private instance of a class called Notification Hub. Then, every time it starts, and this actually might seem like an over
overkill, too much.
An overkill. However, you have to re-register every time the app starts.
Yeah, that makes sense.
This is because the channel URI that we're going to get from WNS can change at any time, mm-hmm. and the guideline says that those have to be updated every time.
Tell it that I'm still here and I'm listening.
Okay, so we create a new notification hub. We need to give a path. This was called Azure Friday. And then we need to get a piece of credentials. Okay. Where do we get that? Of course, from the portal.
Right, so it was like a SQL database has a connection string, and this hub has a connection string.
That is correct. So
connection strings are usually in the dashboard. And there it is.
And there it is. You will see that there are two SAS rules. You can create more. You can create more connection strings with different rights. But the two ones that you're going to use most likely, one is the default listen shared access signature, which basically you just want to use for people for the devices which are just going to receive the notifications.
Okay.
You do not want people hacking your app to be able to spam millions of people.
So we're listening here then.
Listening here. So we take this connection string, we paste it here.
All right.
And then we're going to create a little async method to perform the registration.
Control comma will bring that up too.
Yeah.
OK, so you just made that new function there.
I made it async.
OK.
So what I want to do now is basically talk to WNS and get a new channel. I need to get my channel URI. So I'm going to wait for this class called push notification channel manager.
OK, so you're going to go and ask it.
This is control comma?
Control period.
Period. OK, in here, this is a static method. Create a push notification channel.
For an application.
For the application. This is not a secondary tile.
That's kind of a long function name.
It is. It's very precise, though.
It is.
Now I have my channel. Mm-hmm. And then what I want to do, I want to register for native notifications, which means that we will actually send the specific native payload, the WNS ones.
OK.
And in here, we actually want to get the URI from the channel.
OK.
Oh, sorry. This has to be awaited.
Right, because this is all non-blocking.
This is all non-blocking.
All right, cool.
So this is everything that we have to do to set up our app. We're going to launch this app. This app, of course, is a blank app. It's not going to do anything.
Yeah, it's just going to sit there with an X and hang out. All right, so it's sitting around.
But
there's the init. Okay.
There's the init. So what happens is that now I'm going to get my channel URI, and you see here. I have, this is going to be very small,
right,
but here is the
URL.
Big long URL.
Yeah. Okay.
And then I'm going to talk to the notification hub, say, hey, I actually have this channel URI. I'm registered to receive notifications.
All right.
Now, this app, of course, is doing nothing. We can stop it.
All right.
And now we can send notifications to it.
Let's do it.
This could be deployed on millions of apps, and all of these are doing these things. You don't have to change anything in your code.
Okay.
Now, we will send a notification using console app.
I like console apps.
You can actually do it from your box. I mean, even in production, you might have like a console, like an editing app to craft notifications.
Right,
you have an editorial team.
So I could build this into my existing CMS or some kind of application I have, whether it be web-based or anything.
It doesn't have to be like in the cloud. It doesn't have to be in your mobile backend. Okay. It can be from anywhere.
All right.
So now from here, we're basically going to do the same thing. First thing, we're going to get the .NET NuGet package to access this the notification hubs. So again.
So the same exact stuff, this one here.
This one is different, though. Because what we downloaded earlier was the client SDK, which only allows you to register. Now, what we want, we actually need the one that allows you to send notifications, to do a lot of other management things. So you have to install the Windows Azure Service Bus for .NET.
Okay.
So you install this SDK. And what happens here, you're going to have, use a class. Let me increase the size. We're going to use a class that's called Notification Hub Client.
Control dot.
Nice. And then Notification Hub Client.
Okay.
What we're going to do? We're going to create one from the connection string.
The connection
string. Basically, the same thing we're doing before. And then we have to do.
Azure
Friday is the name of our hub.
Okay.
Now, earlier we got the listen key. Now we actually need the full access key.
I see. Because we are the administrator, for lack of a better word.
Yes. So we basically that allows to query for registrations, get the channel eyes of everybody. You really do not want to allow people to do this.
Okay.
So now that you do this, what you have to do, you have to have you're sending a notification. Let's get the XML template for that. I have it here. This is the XML template for.
So this is what Windows Notification Systems Services wants when someone wants to send some toast.
That is correct.
And I assume Google and iOS are different.
Yes. So in here, you can pass anything you want. We do support raw notification tiles, secondary tiles, everything that you want to use, you can put it in.
Okay, so popping up a toast is different than updating a tile.
That is
correct. I can use that for updating tiles too.
The XML is different. We are completely passed through, so every time that the WNS adds a new feature, you can just use it right away. We do not have to support it.
Oh, okay.
So we're basically just passing the payload that you give us to WNS. Mm-hmm. If WNS says something bad, we're going to tell you in the telemetry and the monitoring.
So then on the iOS side, they don't have live tiles, but they do have badges. You can push
badges,
a number.
Alerts, sounds. You can send a passbook. Push notifications.
Oh, okay.
That is
cool.
Like another kind of format.
Oh,
we do not have to. You do not have to use anything special. It's just a normal push notifications. You can use our system too.
It really is a hub.
It really is a hub.
Okay, that's cool.
So, and then what we're doing here, we're going to send Windows notification.
Oh, yeah. Send Apple. Send Google. Send Windows. Okay, cool. Let's do it.
And from Windows, we're going to send a toast.
All right. Is that it?
Actually, wait. This is. And the sync method, we actually have to wait. And this is it.
That's
so
cool.
Let's see if it worked.
First try? No way.
Let's see. And
so that, how do we know it went up into the sky?
It should pop up there, and it's not popping up there.
Does the app have to be running?
No, the app does not have to be running.
Okay.
Okay.
So this is good.
Okay, why this is not working?
That's great. It's good when it doesn't work, because then we all learn something.
Okay, so.
Well, can you look and see if it showed up as a message that got delivered?
Yes, it
Let's
will
do that.
Take some time, though, because the telemetry takes like 5 minutes to go there.
So if this happens to someone who's doing Hello World, what are the things that they're going to want to check for?
The thing is that the first thing, there is a tool that it is called Service Bus Explorer that they can use to debug these things. And actually, we're just shipping in like 1 week.
Yeah,
we're going to have a nice debug send in the portal to solve these problems.
Okay, cool. Okay. How do we know if it's us or if it's something wrong up in the sky?
Exactly. So you can use this tool that's called Service Bus Explorer. You can just ping it and you download it. It's a sample. One thing that you can do is that you go in here from the notification hub.
Right, because I want to know, is it in the queue?
Yes. You go in your namespace. You get the connection information of your namespace. So this guy here.
Okay. So that's the location of the larger service bus that we're living in.
And in here, you're going to connect. You're going to connect using a connection string.
So you're pasting it in there to the endpoint, and then this is going to show us what's sitting in the queue ready to be delivered.
It's going to show you all my hubs.
Oh, and there's Azure Friday.
Okay, there's Azure Friday here. What I can do is that I can say, what are all my registrations? Yeah. Did I actually register correctly?
Cool.
So I'm going to query for all my registrations and say, hey,
one.
I actually do have one, Windows.
And the time.
This is Windows. This was right now.
Yeah.
And this is my channel URI.
Okay, so, actually so that means the app does exist.
The app does exist.
Okay, that's
now,
cool.
Now, what can we do? I can send a test notification with Windows.
So this is good. This means that the registering part succeeded.
Yes.
Okay.
And here, I can basically create like a gazillion of templates
hello
here.
Hello, world, toast.
I'm going to say hello.
Okay.
The nice thing that this does now is that it creates the XML for me.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to send this notification.
Okay.
And in here, it's going to tell me the registrations that were...
So if this failure one.
Exactly. So what is this guy...
So notification results.
It's telling me that it is...
It's pretty long.
Yeah, this is going to be
outcome.
In
the token obtained from the token provider.
Oh, then was it the beginning?
No, I think we have a little improvement for your app here.
Yeah,
we have a word wrap.
This is true.
Tell the people.
But this is going to be in the body.
Sure.
In the portal. Sorry. All this feature is
going to
be
so I
in
won't
the
have
portal.
To run this.
You will not have to run this application.
So like what's the error here? Can I
so
copy
it
paste
seems
that?
That? It seems that the token.
Put that in a notepad.
Let's see. Is wrong.
Okay. Let's make that a little bit bigger so people can see that.
Yeah.
So the token obtained from the token provider's room. What does that mean? What token?
The token is actually the my credentials.
Oh, okay.
So what happens is that to send to WNS, the notification hub is getting a token from Windows Live.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, the credentials that I pasted
from the Windows Live.
Did you pick it
from a different, maybe perhaps the wrong application?
Yeah. Maybe that's probably the.
All right. Let's check it out.
What I can do is that I can
so use... So here, this is authenticating your service. Was that the right one?
Yeah, exactly. So maybe this one is the wrong, packet SID. So what I will have to do is that I will have now to go inside my app. And of course, I have to sign out of this and sign in with the other one.
I see, because you're signed in as... You've got your Azure guy who you signed in, and now you've got your other guy over here. This is a little longer than a typical Azure Friday, but when things go wrong,
guys.
But when things go wrong, which they do when people are
exactly
because this isn't about demo. This is really important. This isn't about demos. You know what I'm saying? It's about real world type stuff.
Yes, and wrong token is basically means that there's a mismatch.
Right.
So the other times that it can happen is when you did not associate your app with, and here I get my. Authenticating my service.
Okay.
And here it is. Oh, it was zero. It was a different one.
So it was the wrong one. So let's do that now. So go ahead and.
In here.
Now you did log out of your Windows authentication.
So
are you going to be okay here?
No, I have to re-log in with my.
You think you'll be okay?
Yeah,
yeah I think you'll be fine.
It will ask me to.
No, you're okay.
Oh, I'm okay. Great.
All right. So now you're going to go back. Let me see if I understand correctly. You go back into Notification Hubs. Here, I'll tell you what to do because I'm learning. You go into Azure Friday, then you go to Configure.
Correct.
And then under Windows, you're going to copy over both the package SID and the client secret from the correct application.
From the correct application. So from here,
okay. So
we're going to get this guy.
Yeah. So this is almost like as if you were connecting to a SQL Server and your connection string, you just swapped them. You picked the wrong ones.
Exactly.
Okay. So then client secret. More secrets are being told today.
It's okay.
Now, do you need the trailing space? It's okay?
The trailing space is
trimmed.
Going to be trimmed, yes. That was one of the first things that we...
that's an easy bug to find. Okay, so now try it.
Now we're going to go back here. We're going to debug this one.
So you're starting the console app. he goes and up.
Oh, and here
from
it is.
Any.net. See, look at that.
There it is.
Very cool. Okay, so that's notification hubs, Windows Azure notification hubs. You find that under App Services, underneath Service Bus, and hey, it's Azure Friday.